I'm Dr. Vedant Kabra. I'm a cancer surgeon and I'm heading Department of Cancer Surgery at Manipal Hospital, Delhi. I will be talking about advances that have been made in surgical treatment of cancer over the last few decades. We have moved from maximum tolerable treatment to minimum effective treatment in order to achieve maximum cure. And what does that mean? So let me divide this into various heads. And the first is, our emphasis is on organ and function preservation. By which, if I give you an example, for example, oral cavity cancers. There was a time when even for a small cancer, the cancer along with the jawbone and all of the neck nodes, they were removed as one piece, even if the jawbone was not involved. But now, if the cancer is away from jawbone, we don't need to remove it. So we preserve that organ. Even if the cancer is very close to the jawbone, we remove only part of it, thus maintaining the continuity of the jawline. But sometimes we need to remove even the whole of jawbone, like this segment of jawbone or a very large segment of jawbone. In those cases, we can reconstruct and reform that organ, and also to a large extent, some of the functions also can be restored. Similarly, for breast cancer, there was a time when whole of the breast was removed for all breast cancer patients, along with the muscles which were on the chest wall. And then it used to give a very ghastly look after the surgery. With more research, we understood that the muscles don't need to be removed. And with further research, we realized that even if we remove only the tumor with some normal surrounding breast tissue and not the whole breast, it will give the same amount of survival as a removal of whole of the breast in many of our patients. Then came the advent of breast conservation surgery. Moving further, we also saw that just doing a plain breast conservation surgery may not give adequate cosmesis. And then was added oncoplastic breast surgery, which means we remove that part of the breast, mold the remaining part of the breast to give adequate shape. Sometimes the size is smaller as compared to the other side, and then we need to do size correction on the opposite side if the patient agrees to it. Even after total removal of breast, immediate reconstruction can be done. Or even a later reconstruction after the treatment is over can also be done, thus giving a good form of the breast, and the cosmetic outcome is very good. For larger breast tumors, chemotherapy can be given first, they are made smaller, and then breast conservation is done. The other part of breast cancer treatment is treatment of the armpit nodes, which are here. So there was a time when we used to remove all of those nodes, thus resulting in swelling of the arm on that side in around 25 to 30% of the ladies who underwent this surgery. But now we know that if nodes are not involved and if we can find it out during surgery, then we don't need to remove all the nodes. In fact, research has gone a step ahead, and if nodes are minimally involved, then also we are able to save removal of the remaining nodes. And after this surgery, the rate of swelling of the arm decreases to less than 5%. Rectal cancer is another tumor where the normal passage of stool was not preserved in a very large number of patients. But with advent of chemotherapy and radiation protocols, more advanced techniques of surgery by use of staplers, we are able to save the normal passage of stool in most of our patients. Now lastly, coming to bone cancers, there was a time when we used to amputate the limb, just chop off the limb to remove the cancer. But with advent of better chemotherapy and with very good implants, we give chemotherapy, reduce the size of the tumor, which is the most common bone cancer like osteosarcoma, and then replace the joint with an artificial implant, after which patient is able to perform his or her daily activities quite routinely and normally.